Okay, welcome to the lecture related to SCI, and the topic is basic of hierarchical task analysis, HTA in short. So let's start with our slides. So task analysis forms an important part of user requirement analysis, and here you can see the in requirement analysis, user profile, user task analysis, platform constraints, usability, design principles. And one of the important point is user task analysis. So task analysis is a study of users, workflow patterns, conceptual framework, and sequential execution of interaction with the GUI, graphical user interface. And the task analysis results in an user mental map of how he see break down goals into a series of smaller tasks and sequence them. So in here you can see the task analysis focuses on the understanding the user, main user, okay, user is the target main, okay, in case of SCI, and user's goals and how they achieve them, okay, personal, social, cultural characteristics related to user bring to their task, and physical environment's influence on users, okay, the influence of previous knowledge and experience on how users think about their work, and workflow users follow to perform their tasks. So here you can see three steps related to tasks. Okay, so first is the goal, so state of the system that a human wants to accomplish. Okay, then second, task, human activities required, used or deemed necessary to achieve a goal. Okay, and then action, third one, so steps required to complete the task. Okay, so what is the basically task, the second point. Okay, the set of human actions that contributes to a functional objective and the goal of the system. Again, the task analysis defines performance of human and not the computer's performance. Okay, so task analysis means understanding users' need, sequencing them into a series of hierarchical acts, or simply we can say interactions, so as to facilitate the achieving of the goal. Okay, so here is the illustrations. Okay, an example, making a phone call. So users need to communicate with a particular individual, goals to is to inform and seek feedback from that individual in a particular context. So here is the action part, putting on the phone, okay, dialing the number, then communicating conversations, and then ending the call. Okay, so here you can see the sequence of actions, or you can say steps. So there is a sequence and a hierarchy of actions to be followed, and one cannot go to the next step in making calls unless the previous one is complete. So all the steps or actions are in sequence. Okay, you cannot go skipping one. Okay, so task analysis includes user's goal, user's need, user's intentions. Okay, then understanding user's environment, context of use, and the planning of the actions. So we will study about all these three details related to task analysis. So task analysis has direct implication in software design, okay, because it is user oriented analysis, or user based analysis. Okay, so hierarchical task analysis is decomposing task into subtasks and analyzing the logic of sequence needed to execute the task to achieve the set goals in an optimal way. Okay, so there are techniques for analysis. Okay, and before that we see that what is hierarchy. So a hierarchy is an organization of elements that according to prerequisite relationship describe the path of experience a learner must take to achieve any single behavior that appears higher in the hierarchy. Okay, so on the basis of this the technique for analysis are first task decomposition. Okay, simply split task into subtasks in sequence. Okay, then second one is knowledge based technique. Okay, so what what users need to know is important. Then this analysis involves description of tasks in terms of like goal they achieve after execution. Okay, and we can simply represent the goals in states. Okay, then second steps is steps, different steps involved. Okay, and then third one is relevant contextual information. So all these three tasks or descriptions are important in case of analysis of task. So here you can see an example, task decomposition example. Okay, split task into subtasks in sequence. So simple, here you can see task 1, 2, task, simply there are steps 1.12, 1.13, okay. And it shows some, you can say, steps, okay, related to achieving the goal, okay. And it requires some mental or physical demands, okay. And flexibility, frequency, dependencies, okay, steps, subtasks, goals, output. And again, at last, 1.11, task output is important, okay. And again, at 1.12, risk resulting from error, or 1.13, safety critical demands are also important. So, example of a decomposition, you can see a form, okay. So, a forms here represent to enter user's detail, okay. So, HTA provides a consistent logical description of interdependencies of tasks, and therefore, form a rational framework for description of possible user interface architecture based on which a GUI is visualized. So on the basis of this visualization, you can see this form here, okay. And here is the detail, we have to enter the detail related to purchasers, okay. So purchaser has a name, phone, postal code, for province, city, delivery address, today's date, credit card number, okay. So here are some steps related to completing this task. So there are several tasks decomposed. So first, task 1, feed in address information to order book, okay. Then locate the full name field, move the insertion point to the field. Then again, subtask 1.1, type the full name, okay. So here are some actions. So action 1, locate the address line 1 field. Then action 2, move the insertion point to the field. Then action 3, type the address, okay, optional. Is the locate the address line to field, okay. Then again action 4, move the insertion point to the field. Then next action is 5, type the address, okay. Then again subtask 1.2, locate the town city field, okay, and move the insertion point to the field. So to fill this form, we have several tasks, several acts, and several subtasks, okay. Again, here is collecting users data for task analysis, okay. So how to collect the data, okay. So there are several methods to collect the data. So starting point for the task analysis is the user main you can say element or main part of the task analysis. So first is the ethnography, okay, observing and noting user's behavior in the user context. Okay, we will get some information from this observation. Then second, protocol analysis, okay. So observing and documenting actions of the user by validating user's mental thinking, okay. We have to set up some rules and protocol, okay. On the basis, we can analyze the protocol using this method, protocol analysis, okay. Then making users think aloud to understand the user's mental model and logic. It is also important here in HCI and as well in AI. Then the third one is interviews. So there are lots of you can see information from these interviews, okay, based on the some questions, okay. And again questionnaire sets, okay, fourth one. So there are lots of questions can be asked to the user to collect the data, okay. And here you can see a representation related to the task, okay. So task have some questions, or you can say identifying the mental model, okay, and logic related to users. So here you can see first intention and context, okay. It shows the mental model related and logic related to the user, okay. And then what happens next is the questions asked to the user about an action or task, okay. Then what subtask follows, okay, steps are follows by users. Then what happens before, okay. So you can compare the previous actions or subtasks with upcoming task or subtask or action, okay. So again, here is the tool, okay, modeling user data for HTA tool. So there are several tools available to represent those analysis, HTA analysis, okay. So first is the affinity diagram. And it is similar data or similar actions are grouped together. Okay, here similar data and similar actions are grouped together into categories, letting a pattern emerges in the form of a diagram. Okay, so simple one, affinity diagram. Then sticky notes or cards are used to scribble labels. Okay, simply like sticky notes used in daily life for time management. Okay, and again or event management. Okay, so these are the grouped and regrouped till a pattern that shows affinity of different grouping becomes evident. Okay, so there are again degree of affinity is used while determining hierarchy of actions or hierarchy of information. So you can see a representation of affinity diagram with stick notes or cards. Okay, so there are different groups and they are combined in a hierarchy. Okay, so group 1, group 2, group 3 are combined into a single hierarchy. So modeling user data for HTA, so there are other tools. Okay, so simply flow diagram. Okay, already you know about DFD and flow diagram. So indicate information through a system. They illustrate dependencies of the system elements and how information moves one from another. Okay, and again they can also be indicative of roles that are assigned with an organization and how data moves between these assigned roles as well as between organization as a whole or the outside world. So basically data flow diagram shows a flow of data. Okay, or simply goals or states. Okay, and here you can see an example of flow diagram. Okay, showing flow of information in an organization executing the task of checking stocks and ordering supplies in the next slides. Okay, again we can call it as DFD. Okay, short form for data flow diagram, and it is a standard form of depiction used in information system or design in system engineering. So here is the example. Okay, data flow diagram for checking stocks and placing orders. Okay, or simply you can say an part of inventory system. Okay, so there is manager, supplier, stock clerk, receiving stock file, purchase order. So these are all are tasks. Okay, or goals and actions performed on those tasks. Okay, and each individuals have a relation with other tasks or subtasks here. Okay, so data flow in the above diagram depicts a manager calling for stock list from the stock clerk, who gets it from the database M2, and then purchase order is placed and filed in database M1. Okay, so there are two databases, M1 and M2, you can see here. Then clerk 2 receives stocks from suppliers and acts further, dotted line. Okay, so there are tasks and subtasks related to getting the orders and inputting the stock details. Okay, so again there are another tool. Okay, related to modeling this, so sequence diagram. Okay, so sequence diagrams, you can see here a example also. Okay, related to book, online book shopping. Okay, so we will discuss it here. So sequence diagrams are procedural analysis diagram. Okay, simply. And while flow diagrams track work through a system, a sequence diagram uses time to check actions and decisions. Okay, so sequence diagrams are critical. Okay, because they give the object, function, and attribute of a system, which in turns are used to derive the UI, user interface, information architecture. Okay, so here tables are also sometimes used to indicate sequences. So you can see first step, order book online. Okay, so it book is the object. Okay, then there is a function, locate. Okay, so sequence 1, S1, so locate preferred shop online. Okay, then sequence S2, here is the attribute specific. Okay, so locate specific book. Okay, then S3, so again the both object and function combined here, so add book to shopping cart. Okay, and then S4, order book online. So these are the steps in sequence. Again, some chart notations are used for STA. Okay, structure chart notation. There are more than one notation found in literature. Okay, here you can see some notations. So first is sequence. Okay, then iterations, then selection, and unit task. Okay, so in unit task only a single user or single task. Okay, but in sequence there are different subtasks or actions. Okay, in iteration, unit task can be iterative. Okay, so it may it convert into iteration. Okay, and then selection, on the basis of different tasks or subtasks, or you can say conditional choice related to task, you will have a selection. Okay. Then again, here is example HTA diagram for making a call. Already we have discussed in our previous slides. Okay, so simply call a friend. Okay, then action 0 or 1, then 2. So here is the conditional choice. Okay, so locate number in the phone list. If you don't know, then if you know their number, then call simply. Then action 1, 3 when connected, and 3.2 at end of task. So in case of 3, if call is connected, then talk easily. Okay, then if there is no connection, then end call. Okay, so here are the task name. Okay, task goal, output, task steps, task frequency, task flexibility, task dependency, physical mental demands, task output. So this example shows all the related concept related to HTA. Okay, and here each task is also again converted into different or decomposition performed on this task of making a phone call. Okay, subtasks are shown here. Okay, or decompose into subtasks. Each task is decomposed into two or more than two subtasks. Okay, so again here is the case study. So we will not see this case study here. Okay, it is a cultural festival related to IIT Guwahati. So you can go through these slides, and then you can understand more about HTA. Okay, so I will not discuss this case study here. You can go through yourself. Okay, so thank you. So related to this topic, here we complete the HTA, basics of HTA. Okay, then again we will study more about related to task analysis in next lecture. Okay, so thank you.